Hello everyone, this is Monalisha Padi. I am a legal intern at Lexis & Company and I am in third year of BBA LLB at Bharati Vidyapeeth Nirlo College Pune. And today's topic is right of decent burial and rights of dead in India. Rights of dead person came in light in the wake of incidents around the country where people denied decent burial to the deceased person because they succumbed to COVID-19. The Madras High Court took cognizance of an incident that took place in Chennai where the remains of a 55-year-old doctor who died of COVID-19 were denied burial by protesting mobs. Soon after his death, his mortal remains were taken to T.P. Chatram burial grounds in Kalpak for burial, but close to 40 residents gathered there to protest. Without any luck in convincing the protesters, they proceeded in Velangadu burial ground where a similar thing happened and a mob of around 70 people gathered and attacked the officials with sticks and stones. Cases were booked under Sections 18, 147, 148, 341 of Indian Penal Code and Tamil Nadu Private Property Prevention and Laws of Act. A division bench comprising of Justice M. Nirmal Kumar and M. Satharayanan took sorta motu cognizance of this incident. The bench stated, citizens are not expected to take law and order into their hands, and if it is so, would definitely lead to anarchy. There is likelihood of similar kind of incidents to occur in future also. The court issued notice to the Tamil Nadu government as well as at the police and observed that the scope and ambit of Article 21 includes the right to have a decent burial. The court also invoked the highlighted Section 297 of the Indian Penal Code, which deals with the offence of trespassing on burial places. The law in India does not expressly state that burial cremation of the dead is the responsibility of the state, but is interpreted by the courts in this way time and again. However, there are other rights of death that are expressly stated in our laws. Section 404 of IPC recognizes dishonored misappropriation of dead men property as an offence. Further, Section 499 of IPC, which deals with defamation, stipulates that libel or slander against a dead person also constitutes the offence of criminal defamation. Section 403 of IPC, which defines criminal intimidation, includes threatening a person with injuring the reputation of a dead person dear to him as an offence. Section 297 of the IPC, as mentioned above, deals with the offence of trespassing on burial grounds, etc. The right to dignity prevails even after death and is clear from the following precedent set by the Supreme Court of India. In the Suo Moto versus the State of Tamil Nadu, the court was of the opinion that the scope of ambit of Article 21 of the Indian Constitution includes the right of person to have a decent burial. Taking into consideration the facts and circumstances of this case, it is also mentioned that anyone who interferes in this procedure of decent burial shall be liable under Section 297 of the Indian Penal Code, which speaks about trespassing on burial places. The fundamental right to life and personal liberty, which has been guaranteed under Article 21 of the Indian Constitution, has an expanded meaning and the nuances have to be explored using various other judicial pronouncements. As rightly said in the case of Bandhua Mukti Morcha versus Union of India, Article 20 of the Constitution assures the right to live with human dignity. Furthermore, in the case of Common Cause, a registered society versus Union of India 2018, it was contended that the right to die with dignity is an inseparable and inextricable packet of the right to live with dignity. In Setu Raja versus Chief Secretary, the petitioner brought to the court's attention the Supreme Court stand on right to accord decent burial or cremation to a dead body as elaborated in Ram Charan Othanuprasi versus Union of India. The apex court in Pandit Paramanand Katra versus Union of India observed that we agree with the petitioner that right to dignity and fair treatment under Article 21 of the Indian Constitution is not only available to a living man but also to his body after his death. That's all for the topic today. Thank you and have a nice day.